So in today's lecture, we'll discuss about transmission line in course EE352 power system. So why transmission lines are needed? For the transfer of power from the generating station to the load center, it is required. As in previous lecture, we'll discuss about the power system. So what is power system? It consists of generation, transmission and distribution. So this section it is termed as transmission line. This section is known as transmission line. So for transfer the power from the generating station to the load center, this is being used. Now there are different types of transmission line available for transferring the high power, or we say for an EHV system, extra high voltage AC system, there are different types of transmission lines available, like short transmission, line, medium transmission line and long transmission line. So this is the bifurcation or classification of electric transmission line used in extra high voltage AC system. That is short transmission line, medium transmission line and long transmission line. So how we bifurcated or classify it into these categories? It will depend upon mainly the distance or the power transferred or power carried out from the one point to the another point. If the distance is like in is less than 80 to 100 kilometer, so this type of transmission line is known as short transmission line. So in case of short transmission line, the distance or the length of the transmission line will be lies in between lies not more than 100 kilometer. It may be 80 or 100 or less than that. So in this particular type of transmission line, we consider only these parameters: resistance and inductance. We oftenly neglected the capacitance in the short transmission line. When we are going for the analysis of the short transmission line, we only consider resistance and inductance as parameter for the analysis of the line, and we neglect short capacitance because this duration, this destination or the length of the line is so small that the effect on the transmission line will be negligible. Same as in case of medium transmission line, the length of the transmission line will be in between from say 80 km to, it will be more than 80 km, more than or equal to 80 km, and it will be less than the 150 to 200 km, the medium transmission line. The In case of middle transition line, the length of the line will be lies in between this parameter. From 80 to 150, some books it will take 200 km. In for the analysis of this type of transmission line, we consider resistance, inductance, and capacitance also for the analysis purpose. But here we take the capacitance as a lump parameter. Why we take it as a lump parameter? Because the length of the transmission line is not so much long that we will take it as a distributed line. In case of the third category is of long transmission line. So if the length of the transmission line say more than 150 to 200 kilometer, then it will termed as long transmission line. And for the analysis, we will take the following parameter: resistance, inductance, and capacitance. And also, we take the capacitor as the distributed parameter. So by this way, we can understand that there are three types of transmission line: medium, short, and short, medium, and long, depending upon the distance. And in case of analysis, we will take these parameters for the analysis purpose. Now, there are some terminology are also used for the analysis of transmission line. So, I write down it. The first terminology will be voltage regulation. When a transmission line is carrying current, there is a voltage drop in the transmission line. So there is a difference between the sending end voltage and receiving end voltage. So that difference, the ratio of the difference between sending end voltage to the receiving end voltage to the receiving end voltage, it is termed as voltage regulation, and mathematically it will be expressed as percentage voltage regulation is equal to Vs minus Vr upon Vr multiplied by 100, where Vs is the sending end voltage Vr is the receiving end voltage. So sending end voltage, receiving end voltage. So if you consider if you take this take a simple circuit or simple power system, generation, distribution, this is the transmission line. So let's say it is having a resistance R and current I is flowing through the conductor, then there will be a voltage drop, say I equal, we are neglecting the inductance and capacitance. So simply we will take this, there will be a voltage drop. So the sending end voltage, this is the receiving end voltage. So obviously the receiving end voltage is less than the sending end voltage. Receiving end voltage is less than the sending end voltage because of the drop in the voltage drop in the transmission line. Hence, we prefer the lines which are having low voltage regulation. As the voltage regulation is less, the more power will be transferred, or another word we can say that then there will be less voltage drop in the transmission line. So we prefer that there will be very less voltage regulation should be there. Now the second term we'll take is transmission efficiency. The second term we'll take is transmission efficiency. So what is transmission efficiency? The ratio of receiving end power to the sending end power of a transmission line is known as transmission efficiency. So the ratio of receiving end power to the sending end power of a transmission line is known as transmission efficiency of that particular line, and it will be expressed as receiving end power of the sending end power multiplied by 100, or simply we can say VR IR cos of phi R divided by VS IR cos of phi R multiplied by 100, where VR is the receiving end voltage, IR is the receiving end current, cos phi R or phi R is the angle between VR and IR, same as IS sending end voltage, VS sending end voltage, IS sending end current, and phi S is the angle between sending end current and sending end voltage. So this is also an important term in case of analysis of the transmission lines. Now we'll go for the performance analysis of short transmission line. Performance analysis of short transmission line. So I make a schematic diagram of short transmission line here. I is the load current, R is the resistance or say loop resistance of both the conductors, XL loop reactance, VS sending end voltage, VR receiving end voltage, and also there is an cos phi R, that is receiving end power factor. this will be Vs. So this is the phasor diagram representation of a short transmission line. Now, from this particular phasor diagram, we write the expression, that is Vs is equal to, and this here also the resultant of this, resultant of drop across resistance and drop across the inductor will be written as I into Z, this is Vr. So let's take Vr as a reference phasor. I write here Vr as a reference phasor, so it is Vr plus J0, and Vs, how I can write Vs? Vs is equal to Vr plus I Z. Vr plus Iz, where I, it will be Is, because the we take as a series circuit, so Is will be equal to Ir, and we'll take it as a I load current. Here we can write the Is for calculating the sending and voltage, and Is we can written as I into cos phi s minus j sin phi r. And Z will be the R plus J XL. So for calculating the value of Vs, we can write from here, we put the value of Vr from this equation 1, say this is equation 1, this is equation 2, this is equation 3. So Vr will be taken from equation 1, Is will be taken from equation 2, Z will be taken from equation 3, and will get the sending expression for the sending end voltage. So by this way we can analyze the medium short transmission line. As I told you earlier, in case of short transmission line, because of the length is low or less, we neglect the effect of capacitance. Here also one more thing I would like to add, that is percentage voltage regulation, percentage voltage regulation for the short transmission line, it will be Vs minus Vr. So it will be, we'll calculate from here, we got Ir cos phi r minus Ixl sin phi r / Vr multiplied by 100. So by this way we analyze the short transmission line. Now the from these derivations and the phasor diagram, we conclude that when the load power factor is lagging, or unity or such leading, that Ir cos phi r is greater than Ir Sir, I XL sin phi r, then the voltage regulation will be positive. If this is more with respect to this, then the voltage regulation is positive. And this receiving end voltage will be less than the sending end voltage. But for a given VR and IR, the voltage regulation of line increases with the decrease in power factor for lagging load. So there are two points which we should consider. Number one, when IR cos phi r is greater than IXS sin phi r, the voltage regulation or percentage voltage regulation will be positive, and the receiving end voltage will be less than the sending end voltage. Second, for given VR and I, for given receiving voltage and I, the voltage regulation of the line increases. Increases with respect to decrease in power. So these are the two points which we come to know from this expression.
Okay.